brace yourself, because what you see here is pretty disgusting. Well, I was warning you, this is the photos from my first rental property experience. They're pretty brutal, but today I'm going to talk to you about the tips that I've learned and how it ended up like this. Hello everyone, I'm Ethan Rooshock, and on today's video I'll be talking to you about my first experience as a rental property owner, and I'll be going through the worst smell that I've ever smelt. So the worst smell I've smelt has come from this rental property experience, and I'll get straight into it. It was a fridge that was left out of the front of the property. I don't actually have a photo of it, but I opened it up and oh my god, it was the worst smell I have ever smelt. Look, I'm not sure what had been in there. It smelled like maybe rotten fish or something. The fridge was taken away the next day by the tenant, but yeah, this quickly braced me for what I was about to experience next. So I'll go through some photos here of what I walked into, but as you can see, the house was disgusting and the real estate agent had told me, look, be prepared, it hasn't been cleaned yet and it's pretty bad. But when I walked through, wow, I really wasn't expecting it to be that bad. So some of these rooms, like the spare room here, I had to pull out the built-in robes because I could not get rid of the smell even 6 months later. It was just the smell that had seeped into all the wood of the built-in robes and even the floorboards below. And even no matter how much cleaning I put into it, how much products I put into it, I just could not get rid of that smell. So the story behind it, I moved out of the property. I was previously living in it. And I moved into my dad's house to try and save some money. Great money saving tip. I'll get into that in another video. But I rented out for only 8 months. And this is how it was left after 8 months. So I was very lucky that there was actually very minimal things broken. So despite these disgusting pictures you've seen, not really anything was broken. There was one door leading to the bathroom that was a bit damaged that I've replaced. And the back lawn was dead, which obviously required stuff to try and fix that. But nothing was actually broken. There wasn't holes in walls or stuff like that, which was a good thing that the cost wasn't huge to get it back up to a livable standard. And so I was lucky that the bond itself covered a lot of the cleaning costs. So I wasn't too far out of pocket when it came to getting it back to livable standard. But there's definitely stuff I've had to do over the last couple of years that I've noticed as a goal. And like I said, about replacing built-in cupboards, that the smell just wouldn't go away. So when it comes to actually renting it out, money-wise, during that 8 months, I broke even pretty much. So the rent was actually pretty good. It was well and truly above the interest I was paying on the loan. Once you add into your other expenses like your insurance and your council rates, I was still in front. But then because it was only a short period of time, I paid quite a bit of fees to a letting fee and your normal management fees of the property, which probably meant I come out about even during that time period. If you do factor in the money I've spent though on getting the lawn back up to standard, repainting, although that wasn't directly related to the tenant, and some of those other cleaning costs and stuff I've had, I probably did slightly lose out on it. But over a long period of time, I actually think it would be quite a good investment property, and that's what I plan on doing with the property long term. So before I go into the few tips that I'd recommend for people that are renting out a property, I will show you some of the after pictures. So this is what the house is looking like now. All it's taken is a coat of paint, a bit of varnish on the back veranda, a coat of paint outside, and it hasn't cost me a lot of money, and it's definitely really improved the property. So my next plan is to upgrade the bathroom. And once that's done, I feel like the property is in the position where it would have increased quite a bit in value and also increased from a rental point of view. When I put it back out to market to rent out, I think I'll easily get an extra $10 or $20 a week for it. All right, so next I'm gonna get into some tips, but if you're finding this video at all valuable or even funny if you see some of those images, I'd love for you to hit that like button. And if you haven't hit that subscribe button, it would mean the world to me if you'd hit that. It really helps me grow this channel. All right, so I have three main tips that I would give people who are gonna rent out a property. The first one is to make sure your inspections are carried out. So what happened in my situation is the tenant moved in, and then when it came to their mandatory 3 or 6 months inspection, the agent could never get the time for them to be available, and this carried on, and I didn't push it. I wish I had have pushed it and said, no, I want this carried out and I want the report back, because by not following through on this, I feel like this really allowed the house to get even more out of control than it was. So they did carry out one inspection, I think it was about 6.5 months in, and they did say to me, look, we would probably recommend starting an eviction process if it wasn't so close to the end of the lease period. So I think this is really important. Make sure that whether you're self-managing or whether you've got an agent managing, that regular inspections are carried out, especially early on, because this is when you first don't know the tenant that well. And if you do it at 3 months, then at least you're gonna have some idea of how they're looking after the property. My next tip would be making sure you've got enough funds if the property is vacant. There's no point relying on you needing to rent this out 52 weeks a year, year in, year out, because if that doesn't happen, then you're in a bit of trouble. And it also means you have to be less picky with your tenant. So if you can afford to leave the property empty for a couple months, it'll allow you to search for a better tenant than just having to take the first application you get. And if you're taking the first application, you may not even be able to be picky on money-wise, you may be getting less rent. So it might be better just to be a little bit patient on it, but you can't be patient if you're desperately relying on this money. By having that backup money, it also allows you to evict the tenant if needed. So if you're in the situation I was in and you went in and you seen the property was a mess, you'd have the ability to evict them and know that you're not going to be strapped for cash in those few months that it might be while searching for a new tenant. The next one would be to carefully consider letting pets into the house. So now I can get into some more detail about how some of these disastrous images come about. And it was from a cat that had kittens in my spare room. Yep, pretty gross. So I had a dog in my house previously, let it in the house. The floorboards weren't in great condition anyway, so those scratches and stuff didn't bother me. So I thought, oh, well, I might as well let tenants have pets. That'll make it more of an attractive property for people because a lot of people have pets and struggle to find a property that will allow that. So I thought it was just a no-brainer. So when I found out the tenant had cats, as much as I'm not a big cat fan, but I thought, oh, there can't be too much damage. But nearly all the damage that's occurred in the property is from the pets. The human mess was cleanable. The pet mess and them peeing in the floor and things like that, that's the stuff I've really struggled to fix long term. So if I was ever going to let pets in the house, I'd make it very strict that they've got to be outside only, and I'd want the agent to really follow this up because I wouldn't want pets inside my house again. So the question is, would I rent the house out again? And despite all this, yes, I definitely would. There's a lot of lessons I've learned and a lot of things that I would make sure happened. But overall, despite this, I think renting your house out can be a great strategy, but you've just got to make sure that there's regular inspections carried out, that you've got the funds there that if it's empty or that you can be more picky on tenants and really consider pets. Do you really want pets inside the house? Because the damage can be irreparable or cost major funds to repair. All right, thank you for watching the video. I want to hear from you. What is the worst experience you've had as a property owner? Leave a comment down below. And as always, I'll see you on the next video.